Discuss about the anatomy and physiology for the GNM first years. So in this we are going to discuss about the unit 7, that is digestive system. So in this digestive system we have seen up to the large intestine. So then we are going to discuss about the peritoneum. So the peritoneum also, it is also one of the part in the digestive system, and the peritoneum means it is a serous membrane and that lines the abdomen and covers the abdominal organs. So the peritoneum is the serous membrane, so that covers the abdomen and abdominal organs. So the peritoneum is, it is a one of membrane or the layer, and it can be covers the abdomen and abdominal organs. So what are the organs can be situated in the abdomen, and that organs and the abdomen can be covered by the peritoneum, and it consists of two layers. So the peritoneum consists of two layers, that is parietal peritoneum and the visceral peritoneum. So the parietal peritoneum is lines the wall of abdominal cavity. So the parietal peritoneum, that is a, it covers the abdominal cavity. So the parietal peritoneum, it covers the wall of the abdominal cavity. And the next one is the visceral peritoneum. So it covers the abdominal organs, and the visceral peritoneum means there is a, it covers the abdominal organs, and the parietal peritoneum, it covers the abdominal cavity, wall of the abdominal cavity. So the space between the parietal peritoneum and the visceral peritoneum, the space between these two peritoneal layers, and it is called as peritoneal space. And there is a space between the parietal peritoneum and the visceral peritoneum. So the space, it is called as peritoneal space. So the parietal peritoneum, it covers the wall of the abdominal cavity, and the visceral peritoneum, it covers the abdominal organs. And the next one is the mesentery. So the mesentery is the fold of peritoneum which attaches the different parts of the small intestine to the posterior abdominal wall. So the mesentery means it is the folding of the peritoneum. So the foldings can be present over the peritoneum. It is called as mesentery. So which attaches the different parts of the small intestine. So and the mesentery can be attaches to the different parts of the small intestine and to the posterior abdominal wall. So the mesentery, it is the folding of the peritoneum. It can be attaches to the different parts of the small intestine and the abdominal wall. So next one is the omentum. So the omentum, it is the fold of peritoneum, is omenta. So the folding of peritoneum, which is called as the omenta, and the omenta has a two layers. So that is the greater omentum and the lesser omentum. So the greater omentum is become hangs. So the greater omentum become hangs, and it can be attaches to the around the stomach. So it is a greater omentum, it become hangs around the stomach. So it is the stomach. So around of the stomach, the omentum become hangs. So it is called as greater omentum. And the next one is the lesser omentum. So this is the lesser omentum. So it can be situated, it is become curved. So there is a folding can be present, and it is called as lesser omentum. So it is become shorter. So by this lesser omentum, the blood vessels and the nerves can be passes to the stomach and the abdominal cavity. So it is about the lesser omentum and greater omentum. So the greater omentum, it can be surrounds the stomach and it become hangs around the stomach. So it is a greater omentum, and the lesser omentum it is become shorter, and there is a some of the fold which are present in the above the stomach. So there by this lesser omentum, the blood vessels and the nerves which can be supplied to the stomach and the abdominal cavity. So it is about the omentum, it is a folding of the peritoneum. So there is a two layers consist of greater omentum and the lesser omentum. So next one is the arrangement in males. So there is a peritoneum, it is different in the males and the females. So in the males there is a arrangement of the peritoneum. The peritoneum covers the upper part of the rectum. So in the males the peritoneum, it can be covers the upper part of the rectum, and then it can be passes upper and posterior surface of the bladder. So the mostly the arrangement it is in the males, the peritoneum can be covers the upper part of the rectum, and it passes through the upper and the posterior surface of the bladder, and the peritoneum it covers the rectum and then passes upper and posterior part of the bladder in males. And the next one is the females. So the peritoneum is covers the rectum and passes along the anterior and posterior surface of the uterus. So in the females, the peritoneum can be covers the rectum and anterior posterior part of the uterus can be covered by the peritoneum in the females. So next one is peritoneal sac between the rectum and uterus is called as pouch of Douglas. So there is a peritoneal sac can be present between the uterus and the rectum. So it is called as pouch of Douglas. So it is become like the peritoneal sac is become like pouch. So it is called as pouch of Douglas. So it is arrangement, it is a different in the males and the females. And the next one is the functions of the peritoneum. So the functions it includes the, it covers the abdominal organs. So the abdominal organs which are present in the abdomen, it can be protected from the injury or acidity and by the peritoneum. So the peritoneum can be covers the abdominal organs. And the next one is it helps move abdominal organs without friction. So while moving the abdominal organs, there is a friction can be occur. So it can be prevented by the peritoneum. So the peritoneum can be helps to prevent the friction between the abdominal organs. And the next one is the abdominal organs held in position. So the abdominal organs which are in present in the abdomen, the organs can be held in the position by the peritoneum. So the organs can be in a normal position, can be held in normal position by the peritoneum. And the next one is the omentum. So omentum it is become serve as a storehouse for the fat. So what are the fat can be stored into the omentum. So omentum it can be helps in the storage of the fat. And the next one is it can absorb large quantity of fluids. So the peritoneum it can be absorbs the large amount of fluids. So large quantity of fluids can be absorbed by the peritoneum. So it is the functions of the peritoneum. It includes the, it covers the abdominal organs and it helps move abdominal organs without friction, and abdominal organs held in position, and omentum it is the storehouse of the fat, and it can absorb large quantity of the fluid. So